known unknowns, or new planets in our solar system, or the hunt for the unknown planet.
Now, how much do we really know about star creation, solar formation, and dark
antimatter penetration? I don't care if you're one of the people who think Planet X is 5 times the size of Jupiter and in between the Sun and Venus, or you don't believe any type of Planet X exists at all, ever. 100 years from now, 1,000 years from now, or 1,000,000 years from now. Hey, hardcore Planet Xers, I'm in the tank with you at heart. I'm just trying to teach you something.
Yes, I know.
Whoa,
I better dial it back. Nobody likes preachy teachy.
But stay with me here. I'm taking little steps, lead you to the big picture. Overall, in the math of the Oort cloud, the unknown planet and planets have to exist. Planet dwarf star exists.
Dwarf might have been the lamest science name ever.
Leave it to humans to name a protoplanet or a planet a dwarf.
I mean, can you imagine them like naming a dwarf car?
Yeah, it's the new dwarf Lexus.
No.
Dwarf Twinkies.
Dwarf hamburgers.
This could be a good time, said Oribe,
a Hopi Nation elder.
Just because it's a brand new planet doesn't mean it's bad things.
We don't really know how the universe works, so it could be badass. I mean, like, we don't know how did Earth go from stop making dinosaurs to start making human beings.
Who knows what we're going to be next?
We're going to be, like, extra awesome. Which would be awesome. Why did Earth stop making dinosaurs and start making humans?
We know very little about solar system formation, and that has giant gaping holes in it. The unknown unknown exists.
See, the search for Planet X used to be for all of us classic romantics. But then they tagged it that Nibiru crap and made anyone who even talked about it look like a tinfoil hat wearing booger shake drinking thumb sucker who sniffs his own poop for fun.
There are still many unanswered questions about heavenly mechanics.
Planet X, what is it?
It's the unknown planet. It seems less a planet and more a star. Spectacular.
And if you don't date your shit in 5 billion or so years, when the Andromeda Galaxy collides with the Milky Way, our solar system will most def have a new planet or two in whatever the latest version of our solar system is. So is the Oort cloud the name of our solar system?
It's basic math, man. That in this giant Oort cloud, when they say the Milky Way has hundreds of billions of stars, and it also has to have hundreds of billions of planets, and that suns are moving. I don't know if you knew that, but it's true. As spiral galaxies slowly rotate, the spiral galaxy becomes more twisted up as the spiral becomes tighter, causing all things to contract. I don't know if you knew that, but it's true.
We have explored less than 0.00000000001% of the known universe. Rule number one in the hunt for the unknown planet, do not get bogged down in semantics.
Planet X, the unknown planet, has many names. Herculubus, Wormwood, Marduk, Destroyer, Planet of the Crossing, Tiamat, Nibiru, Nemesis, Red Kachina, The Winged Planet, Tachi. And each one of those names has its own flavors that go along with the legend. Wormwood from the Bible. But it is strange because common associations that they all seem to have is that it's red. Whatever this unknown planet star dwarvian thing is red.
Surrounded by a giant dust cloud of iron oxide.
Does any of this make any sense? Hey dude, I like beer. And that is not part of this discussion. What we're discussing here is just the unknown planets. Planets we don't know about yet, but there have to be a lot of them. Most of the time, we just looked on the ecliptic for other planets. Like, hey, dude, there are no other planets on the ecliptic, so there are probably not other planets.
Know your garden. Like when they said that Nibiru, it had some association that, like, people were saying that, yeah, giant reptile aliens live on the planet, and they're gonna come here, and they're gonna enslave us, and then they're gonna take all of our gold, our silver, our oil, and our women.
Hey, wait a minute. That does sound like the last 100 years.
But I progress, because progressing is not even a word.
Yes, I know. As far as I know, the most planet X-y of all the new planets, planetoids, dwarf planets, is Sedna. Sedna is a complete and total badass. Sedna makes Chuck Norris look like a wimp.
Sedna makes Chuck Norris look wimpier than a cupcake in a dress.
I mean, it's got a 12,000 to 11,000 year orbit. Who could do that, dude? Who could carve their own orbit out of a 12,000 year circle?
Circly?
Stay with me here. They're slowly assembling the known universe, Milky Way solar system. I got a funny feeling Sedna is made of supra iron, or supra ion iron. It's the reddest object known to man. WTF does that even mean? How much of a Wolverine, Thor, Zeus, Hercules hero must you be to be able to clear your own 12,000 year orbit? And if you hardcore Planet Xers have hung on long enough, you will, son of a poop bucket, notice that Sedna has an orbit much like that of the old school sketches of Planet X.
Infrared. Be good to each other.
Planet X.
It's the one legends, mythologies, and religions have spoken of that we don't know. We haven't found yet. How old is the legend?
As old as man writing on caves.
The search has been going on forever. It did kick up into a new gear in the 1980s. We look at the universe and act like we know everything about planets and stars. And we've never stepped foot on a planet or a star. So how much can we know? We're like fish in a pond looking up at a woman on her cell phone. And we, the fish,
we think we can fully understand the intricacies of AT&T's data billing system. Doesn't make any sense.
You prefer to be lightly educated
and strongly opinionated. But that is a habit you can break, you know?
Create community. It is time to speak the truth. Do not look outside yourself for the leader.
Sums of stars like strands of DNA. And why do they assume there are no side suns? Does any of this make any sense? like, hey, dude,
if it's there, we can see it. Which is not true, because in the whole yin and the yang of things, where there is white and black, that the binary companion of the sun, which is light, might be darkness or dark matter. So, if we don't understand dark matter, obviously, our non-existent dark matter cameras are not going to be able to pick it up. And if it is surrounded by a giant dust cloud of debris, its light wouldn't be able to escape it.
Things really heated up in the 80s, and the search for the 10th planet hadn't been given the stigma of tinfoil hat wearers. It seemed that the same thing to do, because I'm going to read Astronomy, Search for the 10th Planet, December 1981.
Astronomers are readying telescopes to probe the outer reaches of our solar system for an elusive planet much larger than Earth. Its existence would explain a 160-year-old mystery.
Pull exerted by its gravity would account for a wobble in Uranus's orbit that was first detected in 1821 by a French astronomer, Alex Bouvard. Beyond Pluto in the cold, dark regions of space may lie an undiscovered 10th planet 2 to 5 times the size of Earth. Van Flandern thinks the 10th planet may have between 2 and 5 Earth masses and lie 50 to 100 astronomical units from the Sun. An astronomical unit is the mean distance between Earth and the Sun. Aha, but here, his team also presumes that, like Pluto, the plane of the undiscovered body is tilted with respect to that of most other planets, and that its path around the Sun is highly elliptical. New York Times, June 19, 1982. A pair of American spacecraft may help scientists detect what could be a 10th planet or a giant object billions of miles away. Space agency said that persistent irregularities in the orbits of Uranus and Neptune suggest some kind of mystery object is really there. With its distance depending on what it is. If the mystery object is a new planet, may lie 5 billion miles, the outer orbital ring of known planets. If it is a dark star type of object, it may be 50 billion miles beyond the known planets. If it is a black hole, 100 billion miles. Newsweek, does the sun have a dark companion? June 28, 1982. When scientists noticed that Uranus wasn't following its predicted orbit, for example, they didn't question their theories. Instead, they blamed the anomalies on an yet unseen planet. According to John Anderson of the Jet Propulsion Lab in Pasadena, California, this odd behavior suggests that the sun has an unseen companion, a dark star gravitationally bound to it, but billions of miles away. Other scientists suggest that the most likely cause of the orbital snags is a 10th planet 4 to 7 billion miles beyond Neptune. Astronomy, searching for a 10th planet, October 1982. The hunt for new worlds has not ended. Both Uranus and Neptune follow irregular paths that observers can only explain by assuming the presence of an unknown body whose gravity tugs at the two planets. Astronomers originally thought that Pluto might be the body perturbing its neighbor, but the combined mass of Pluto and its moon, Charon, is too small for such a role. So they were wrong. Astronomers and scientists wrong, imagine that. First, the object could be a planet, but any world large and close enough to affect the orbits of Uranus and Neptune should already have been spotted. Searchers might have missed a planet, though, if it's unusually dark or it has an odd orbit. Yeah, not close to the elliptic. New York Times, January 30th, 1983. Recent calculations by the United States Naval Observatory have confirmed that the orbital perturbation exhibited by Uranus and Neptune, which Dr. Thomas C. Van Flandern, an astronomer at the observatory, says could be explained by a single undiscovered planet. He and his colleague, Dr. Richard Harrington, calculate that the 10th planet should be 2 to 5 times more massive than Earth and have a highly elliptical orbit. How about this? Mike Brown, the guy who discovered all these planets, the guy who discovered the majority of the new planetoids, who's the guy who discovered Sedna in 2003, said, Sedna is a very odd object. It shouldn't be there. It never comes anywhere close to any of the giant planets or the sun. It's way, way out there on this incredibly eccentric orbit. December 1982, Astronomy, Mysterious Planet X. Something must be out there, astronomers believe, because the orbits of Neptune and Uranus deviate slightly from what they should be, according to the law of physics. A mysterious object, a planet, or perhaps a brown dwarf, seem to be tugging them off course. Can the object be a planet, or is it a brown dwarf? A star that didn't quite make it. Or could it be a neutron star? A star that has gravitationally collapsed into a densely packed, dark remnant of its former luminous self. Which is fascinating because the neutron star is kind of a newer concept, and the more we've learned about it, I would think that the sun has a neutron star, or a binary companion. A brown dwarf or a neutron star, much more massive than a planet, would be located perhaps 50 billion miles away, would tug evenly on both pioneers. A nearby brown dwarf may be located by other means. Although not hot enough to shine, such a dark star radiates in the infrared region of the electromagnetic spectrum. These theories have their critics. Planet X, skeptics say, would have to be as massive as Uranus. If that were the case, it should have long since been discovered by conventional observations.
As the camera went through a technological explosion of awesomeness and goodness and high-quality pixels and power, to now, technologies we have available to all of us are amazing. Even on the data NASA gives us, spectacular.
Rule number two in the hunt for Planet X, don't date your shiz.
Don't date it, man.
Dating only makes you look like a fool. And this goes out to like the Nancy, the Zetas, or the Harold Campos.
Camping? Of the world.
Like if you're gonna date it, I wouldn't argue with Isaac Newton. He's the godfather of science. Or the father of science. So rule number two, don't date your shit in the hunt for Planet X. Rule number three, have an imagination.
I don't know if you're a doom junkie and just want doom.
Like nobody knows when these planets are coming around. That even applies to like NASA. Like when NASA talks about setting as an orbit, if you look at its elongated orbit, one would think that when the planet comes around the corners, it's going to travel a lot faster. And that I think stars can display properties we're not aware of yet. So on something as far as like Sedna, until we know a full rotation, I don't think we know the time, the speed, the place of rotation. So don't date your shit.
Have some imagination. If you just want to look at classically, romantically, like,
hey, this new planet's going to show up and everything's going to be awesome. That is awesome.
If you're a doom junkie, you just want to doom, well, I guess this is as good a place as any, though I would recommend economics.
All doom is in financials.
Ooh.
I shouldn't do that.
My mistake. I let this video get way too big, get way out of hand. I lost my place. Fudge. I apologize to you. But I guess there's no way you're still watching. Because I rambled off and spun out of there to where I was talking about nothing important. Okay. Well, come back now, you hear? Thanks.
Thor News presents Planet X. Known unknowns. Or new planets in our solar system. Or the hunt for the unknown planet.
Now how much do we really know about star creation, solar formation, and dark antimatter penetration?
I don't care if you're one of the people who think Planet X is 5 times the size of Jupiter and in between the Sun and Venus. Or you don't believe any type of Planet X exists at all, ever. 100 years from now, 1,000 years from now, or 1,000,000 years from now. Hey, hardcore Planet Xers, I'm in the tank with you at heart. I'm just trying to teach you something.
Yes, I know.
Whoa,
I better dial it back. Nobody likes preachy teaching.
But stay with me here. I'm taking a little step, lead you to the big picture. Overall, in the math of the Oort cloud, the unknown planet and planets have to exist. Planet dwarf star exists.
Dwarf might have been the lamest science name ever. Leave it to humans to name a protoplanet or a planet a dwarf. I mean, can you imagine them like naming a dwarf car? Yeah, it's the new dwarf Lexus. No. Dwarf Twinkies. Dwarf hamburgers. This could be a good time, said Oribe, a Hopi Nation elder. Just because it's a brand new planet doesn't mean it's bad things. We don't really know how the universe works, so it could be badass. I mean, like, we don't know how did Earth go from stop making dinosaurs to start making human beings. Who knows what we're going to be next? We're going to be, like, extra awesome, which would be awesome. Why did Earth stop making dinosaurs and start making humans? We know very little about solar system formation, and that has giant gaping holes in it.
The unknown unknown exists.
See, the search for Planet X used to be for all of us classic romantics, but then they tagged it that Nibiru crap and made anyone who even talked about it look like a tinfoil hat wearing booger shake drinking thumb sucker who sniffs his own poop for fun.
There are still many unanswered questions about heavenly mechanics. Planet X, what is it? It's the unknown planet. It seems less a planet and more a star.